Hi, this is Bruce Johnston of the Beach Boys at a guard scene. And here's your man on the scene, Ed Bear.
Thank you, Bruce. We're on the scene for the National Guard. We'll be talking with the Beach Boys in just a moment after we hear one of their biggest hits, California Girls.
Well, East Coast girls are hip. I really dig those styles they wear. And the Southern girls with the way they talk, they knock me out when I'm down there. The Midwest farmer's daughters really make you feel alright. And the Northern girls with the way they kiss, they keep their boyfriends warm at night. I wish they all could be California. I wish they all could be California. I wish they all could be California girls. The West Coast has the sunshine and the girls all get so tan. I dig a fringe bikini on Hawaiian island girls by a palm tree in the sand. I've been all around this great big world and I've seen all kind of girls. Yeah, but I couldn't wait to get back in the States, back to the cutest girls in the world. I wish they all could be California. I wish they all could be California. I wish they all could be California girls.
California Girls by the Beach Boys, with us on Guard Scene. And we have Bruce Johnston with us at this moment. Bruce, you're kind of considered the sixth Beach Boy because you joined last. But you've been with the Beach Boys for quite a while now.
Almost 3.5 years.
Well, why don't we discuss how the sound of the Beach Boys has changed?
Well, when I joined the Beach Boys, the sound had just left the surfing and hot rod. Whatever that sound is, because there was more than one group, you know, making the sound, and it started becoming more Beach Boys without any trends being connected to it. And at the same time, I started touring, I guess, in 1965, and we were touring around the United States, and I think we had just recorded California Girls, and that was the first song I recorded with them. And all of a sudden, we started getting letters and things from people in Europe. And so we set up a tour, and we went to Europe, and first of all, we arrived in London, and we couldn't get out of the airport. It was like seeing A Hard Day's Night, the movie. They had 3,000 people at the airport to meet us.
Wow.
I couldn't even believe it. And then we've made about 3 or 4 tours of Europe since then.
I know you're very big in England in particular, because with Good Vibrations, at the time that was popular there, you were the only American group out of the British top 10 in the chart, and you were number one. The rest of them were 2 through 10.
That's funny. It was headlines in the national papers. There's a poll in the biggest music paper over there, which happens to be the biggest music publication, the New Musical Express. Beatles toppled by Beach Boys in world group poll.
Uh-huh.
Then we went over there and we did a concert and everything. So, anyway, the Beatles are our good friends, you know, and that doesn't make them mad or anything.
No,
so at Christmas time, we played for UNESCO or something like that in Paris, and Mike and I went up to London, and the Beatles invited us to their little private Christmas party, and it was a costume party, and I went dressed as one of the Beatles.
Ah, that must have broken them all up, I'm sure. Let's pause now, Bruce, for this word from the National Guard.
Okay.
The National Guard is the action team, the backbone of America's strategic reserve, both on land and in the air. Guardsmen are on call around the clock in the event of a national emergency. They also make the scene when something goes wrong locally, like a flood or hurricane or tornado. They're action guys who are serving their country, and they're proud of it. The National Guard is the in outfit, and the guys in it are men you can be proud of and thankful for. Ed Baer here on Guard Scene with our guests, the Beach Boys. And we'll be chatting with the boys in just a moment after we hear their current smash, Friends.
We've been friends now for so many years. We've been together through the good times and the tears. And each other onto the good things that life has to give.
By the Beach Boys, and it's a pleasure to have them on the show today. We have Mike Love with us at the moment. Michael, it's good to have you here. I know you've been a busy guy, and I'm glad you took time out of your busy day to visit with us.
Thank you, Ed.
What have you been doing lately, Mike, as far as the boys are concerned? You've been on tour, I know.
Well, I've been trying to stay away from the boys as much as possible, proving it by going to India in March for about a month.
Uh-huh.
You know, I went there to check out the Transcendental Meditation scene. I found it very rewarding, believe it or not.
Oh, I do believe. I don't know much about it, and I hope you'll explain a little bit about it.
Well, you know, Transcendental Meditation was taught to the guys in the group by Maharishi in Paris in December when we were doing a UNICEF show. And we were very interested in the effects of it. It really makes you feel peaceful and gives you energy and things like that. It's quite profound what the effects are. Anyhow, we were so interested that we came back to New York, and this is saying pretty much for Californians, you know. We came all the way back to New York, spent a week just listening to Maharishi speak at like Felt Forum when he was here in January, and went up to Harvard to the law forum up there, and he was very fascinating to see him. You know, there aren't too many holy men type Indian people
around
the
anymore.
Western world. Yeah. And it was really quite an experience for us. Now, just after that, I was really deeply interested in finding out how meditation works, really, and intellectually, how to relate it to other people. And I knew what it felt like, but I just wanted to know what's going on, you know, the mechanics of it. So I went to India for about a month, and there got in many lectures and groovy meditations. Got up to personally doing about 6 hours worth of meditation at one time. Yeah, it's really wild. Some people up there were going like 5 days a week. It really gets
Mike, let me ask you, how does this compare with yogi? Is it at all similar?
Yoga?
Yeah,
yogi
crossing
means
your
a
legs
monk,
and
you know.
Oh, yeah.
Realized man. And yoga,
I thought he was a catcher for the Yankees.
Yeah,
but,
he was.
Yeah.
But anyway, he's also a bear.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
My cousin
anyway.
Yogi. Hey, baby.
Right.
Okay.
Anywho, yoga, there are different kinds of yoga. Yoga, I think, means action. So you can say yoga, any kind of yoga. Yoga asanas are exercises.
Yeah.
And pranayama is a breathing exercise type of yoga. And there are different mental exercise type yogas, you know, that are practiced. And transcendental meditation is a form of yoga. Mm-hmm. But it happens to not be that recluse type, the kind that they say that, you know, you get out of life and withdraw and become a, you know, one of those recluse type monks or something.
I see.
This is a thing you do twice a day, once in the morning, once in the evening, and you get back into activity during in between times, and you feel more at peace and more energy, more clarity of mind, and you accomplish what you want to do twice as easily. And it makes you happy at the same time.
I see. Mike, we have to do something right now.
What's
and
that?
That's pause for a message from the National Guard.
I'm okay. For pausing.
Hi, this is Bobby V, and I'd like to ask you all a question. How many disasters do you plan to go through this year? Probably none if you can help it. The point is, no one wants civil disorders, floods, blizzards, or tornadoes, but they happen. And when they do, it's reassuring for you to know that the National Guard is right there on the scene, both during and after the hours or days of danger. The National Guard cannot prevent floods or tornadoes or civil disorders, but they're an action team you can depend on when a local disaster hits your community. The National Guard is one good reason why you can sleep a little sounder tonight.
Thank you, Bobby. Now, that pause wasn't too long, was it, Mike? One more quick question, though, before you go. Is transcendental meditation going to affect the Beach Boys' music in any way?
Well, it just makes it easier to perform, easier to create, and easier to do. We used to take several hours doing tracks, and now last album we averaged about an hour per track, half hour, which is phenomenal for us.
Does this mean you're all thinking together, whereas before you...
Well, it creates more group harmony. Everybody feels better within themselves and creating harmonious type of vibrations.
I'm glad you said vibrations, because we're going to close this edition of Guard Scene with the Beach Boys' big hit, Good Vibrations.
I love the colorful clothes you wear and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair. Gentle on the wind that lifts her perfume through the air.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations.
Softly smile, I know she must be kind. In her eyes, she goes with me to a blossom room.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up
until the next Guard Scene, this is Ed Baer reminding you that the National Guard is an action team you can be proud of and thankful for.
I don't know where, but she sends me there.
Vibration.